On behalf of Vistex, the global leader in go-to-market solutions, I'm Ron Roscoe, and with me today is Scott Hodgson, the Commercial Excellence Director at GE Healthcare. Welcome, Scott.
Thank you, Ron. Thank you for inviting me.
When we talk, or when you mention GE, everybody barely says, yeah, I know who they are, but they probably don't know everything that GE is involved in. Could you give us a little snapshot, please?
Absolutely. As you say, most people have heard of General Electric. We've been around since 1878, formed by Thomas Edison. And most people think of us as being a power company, and that's true. A big part of our business is to help power the world. And a huge focus there is on renewable energy now in terms of protecting the environment. We're also one of the major players in aviation. And the division I'm part of is the GE Healthcare division. So we're there to try and save lives across the world and provide good, affordable healthcare wherever you are. So GE is if I had to describe us with one word, it's a company that changes. And because of the environment we're in at the moment, you'll see GE doing that. We're very good at evolving, very good at making the changes necessary to keep us ahead of the game. And that makes it an interesting place to work. So very much, this is my 30th year in GE, and you know, it's a great place. I can recommend it.
And you're in the pharmaceutical diagnostics area. What's the focus there?
We're actually a pharmaceutical division within a big healthcare equipment organization. So again, most people think about GE Healthcare being a division that provides X-ray systems, big MRI scanners, which is true. I'm a part of the business which is the complete opposite to that. We provide drugs which are actually used in those imaging suites, and they're used in different ways to try and improve the image quality when you're doing a diagnostic procedure. So hence the name pharmaceutical diagnostics. So our drugs are used to help diagnose cancers, heart disease, and most importantly at the moment, we're a leader in terms of helping with neurological diseases such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. We have two product ranges. One is what we call contrast media. This is typically an iodine-based drug that's injected into you in the imaging suite. And the other, which is the most challenging, is actually a nuclear product. It's radioactive. Huge challenge for our supply chain because we have products that have shelf lives measured in hours, if you're lucky, in a couple of days, which means we get an order from a customer, we have to manufacture it, we have to ship it to a hospital to inject it in a patient, in some cases within 8 hours. Wow. So it's just amazing that we can do that. And we do that 97% of the time on time, because what we're really trying to focus on is getting the right dose to the right patient at the right time, because we play such a key part in that healthcare model.
Okay. So let's go back to August of 2016, which is when your Vistex journey began. Something wasn't adding up for GE Healthcare.
So at the time, we were running our contract management system in the US on an old obsolete platform. And to be honest, we have been trying to replace it for 18 months, 2 years. I was brought into the project to say, look, this isn't working. Why isn't things getting done quicker? And the first thing I was told to do is just get the job done, replace the system with the current new model, and then walk out of the door. And I said, I refuse to do that because I'm not sure that that's the right solution. So I spent the first couple of months just saying, what problem are we trying to solve here? And the problem shouldn't be that we just have an obsolete system. The problem should be, why aren't people happy with the current systems that we're using? What we actually learned is that the systems were slow. For us to get a customer with a signed contract ready to do business with us, it could take up to 30 days. That's 30 days of lost business, but 30 days of unhappy customer satisfaction. And that's mainly because we had systems that had to be interfaced into our ERP, which is SAP. And because you have these things running every night, they fail, they're always going to cause problems. We asked the question, well, surely there must be a better solution out there. And that's when we started to look at Vistex. Now, Vistex, because of the architecture, because of the way it's fully integrated within SAP, there are no interfaces. There are no problems that can happen each night. There aren't duplicate customer masters that you have to try and keep in sync. So suddenly, by making that one decision, most of our problems disappeared. So actually, to then implement the new system took us 10 months. It was a challenging period because we still had the issues of trying to replace a project, an existing system quickly. But it actually gave us huge opportunities to look at our business processes. We implemented a chargebacks module. We implemented rebates and admin fees, memberships for our customers, and also looking at government pricing and compliance. So we managed to deliver all of that within 10 months, And within the first year, we saved the business $3.5 million in chargebacks. We've actually now getting huge benefits 3 years down the line because of what we did in that that project.
Okay, so it wouldn't, I guess thinking about that is how much this take, wouldn't it have been easier just to implement the newer version of the current system?
It would have been easier. And actually I said, I can do that and I won't lose my job. I risked my job on Vistex because I believed that was a better solution and it's proved to be correct. So no regrets from my side, but it was a risk at the time. It was a risk worth taking.
Okay, so what was there anything else that wasn't adding up for GE Healthcare?
What we implemented at that time, which we called our revenue management system, really only kicked into effect once you had a signed contract from a customer. And we're a contracts business. That's how pharmaceuticals work. Our salespeople spend a lot of time negotiating prices, terms and conditions with customers. And that whole negotiation process was being done outside of Vistex. And at the time, the rest of GE Healthcare was putting pressure on me to say, well, we have a solution for that. It's called Aptus. Aptus is a great tool. But it brought me back to the same problem statement I had with the revenue management system is there would be a separate system with interfaces with dual customer masters to maintain. That didn't fit our business model of trying to create a fully integrated, seamless system. So again, we went back to Vistex and said, do you have a solution to this? Absolutely. It's called contract lifecycle management. And that's the project that we then implemented going live last year in 2019 in the US. So now what we have is a full end-to-end seamless process from starting negotiations with a customer, having a system that helps us understand our prices and margins, which we never had before, so gross to net. And then, most importantly for me, is once that contract is signed electronically, there isn't any room for human error for somebody to have to then swivel chair and type the information back into our revenue management system or into SAP. It's all fully integrated. It's there at a click of the button. Your price is alive. Your customer can do business with you the next day. We set ourselves the target, actually, of having a customer live to do their first order within 5 working days. It's now 24 hours. And that's a fantastic result for me because quicker to market, quicker to be able to do business, and much happier customers, which is what we've always targeted.
Good. So this global contract management tool that you implemented, you've talked about things that didn't work. Let's talk about more about that global contract management tool that you implemented.
So again, what we did at the start of this project, I'm a big believer, if you spend enough time at the start of a project to understand what's the real underlying issues, you save so much time later on. So what we did is we stepped back and said, okay, what's broken today? We had a system where today a salesperson operating in Salesforce would raise the request. The way they would do that is they would open up an Excel form with all the customer details and pass that through to a pricing team in the back office. The pricing team would put that information into a workflow tool, get the necessary approvals, the sign-offs that we would agree this price. Then it's handed off to the next team, the contracts team, that opens another workflow tool to manage all the terms and conditions to make sure the payment terms are correct, to make sure that we understand what we're signing on the contract. That workflow tool at the end would then go to an electronic signature tool. That was fine. But at the end of the process, we always used to give this example for our sales reps. If they wanted to see a copy of that signed contract, it was like trying to find the Ark of the Covenant from a Indiana Jones film. It's somewhere there in a warehouse. Good luck finding it. So what we did with Vistex is here's another opportunity for us to integrate everything into one tool. So I said I tried to avoid interfaces where necessary, but we did build one interface, and that was between Salesforce.com and Vistex. Because our sales team live in a Salesforce world, our contracts team live in a Vistex world. It's very difficult for people to have to keep learning different tools. Well, we didn't have to. By integrating those two systems, the salespeople start in Salesforce and they raise their request. If they want to do a pricing approval, they can do it in Salesforce. Then that information seamlessly comes over to Vistex so that the pricing team, the contracts team, can then manage all of those approvals, those authorizations, that pricing calculation, which was so important to us, so that then everything is seamless. Using DocuSign to get the electronic signature, and at the end, that most important signed contract is actually stored within our document management system in SAP. We make all of that visible so the sales reps get the information flowing back to Salesforce again. It's a closed circuit loop so that everyone gets visibility. They can see the status of a contract approval. They don't get frustrated that it's disappeared into this black hole of a warehouse. People are comfortable, they're relaxed, they know that things are being actioned and done quickly. And I should add also that one of the main drivers is to make sure we're doing it compliantly. The reason why we wanted a system like Vistex is to ensure that when we do sign contracts, it's fully compliant. We're not opening ourselves up to any risk. We're not opening ourselves up to pricing mistakes. Vistex has given us that confidence now that our data is safe, it's accurate, and the customers can rely on us to make sure we get things right first time.
So does this mean the journey is done?
Absolutely not. So our focus initially has been on the US. I'll be honest with you, the US market is probably the most complex I've seen coming from Europe and the UK. It was a very challenging business to learn. So we started there and we wanted to demonstrate we can build this end-to-end solution. But now we've shifted focus. We're going to Europe. I'm discussing with China, with Latin America. I'm actually getting people from my business who never understood digital tools before calling me, ringing me, saying, when can we get Vistex? We need a tool like this. So I've got a waiting list of things behind me of people that are desperate to get this. But even more than that, what we're actually understanding now, because we have that full integration, it opens up new opportunities because now there's data available that before used to be locked in silos. So if you're a contracts person, you had all the data you wanted. If you're a salesperson, you had the data you had for your activities with salespeople, with customers. But the two things weren't visible to each other. Our sales reps couldn't even see the contract status. They couldn't see a price. That gives them very little power when they're actually having customer negotiations and discussions to know what should I talk about. Using the power of Vistex and putting that into AI tools, analytical tools, which open up the power of that data, now makes us so much more powerful in terms of understanding our customers, understanding their needs, and giving us insights that we can take action on to help grow our business and to support our customers. So this is really just the start of the journey. What we're excited about is how we continue building that with the help of Vistex.
All right, well, this, I'm listening to this, Scott, and this seems like such a huge undertaking. Collaboration had to be paramount to see what to do next.
Absolutely, and I have to say one of the reasons I'm so happy to have built this relationship with Vistex is it's not a sales partnership in terms of Vistex to just see me as a customer, somebody to take money out of. It's a partnership. And that's no more evident than it is at the moment in the situation we have with COVID-19. I work with a number of different software companies in my role. Most of those have been very resistant to support us during this tough period. Every company is going through tough times, there's uncertainty, and everyone needs to try and reassess, you know, do our priorities shift now? And we had to take some tough decisions on pausing some projects, canceling some projects. The difference with Vistex is that conversation was just so much easier, so much more collaborative. You wanted to understand my needs, but more than that, you were asking me, how can you help? I even had your CEO and owner, Sanjay Shah, calling me saying, what more can we do? And we're looking at areas of co-innovation at the moment, where even though we've had to pause some projects, we're still working together in a collaborative way so that we can speed up and hit the ground running when we can restart some of that work. That's what I mean by having a partnership, and the relationship that Vistex has offered me, I can honestly say is better than any of the other suppliers that I'm working with at the moment. And very happy again I made the decision to choose Vistex in 2016.
Fantastic. Well, and speaking of partnerships, I know GE has done some very cool things with organizations such as Ford and Ecolog during this pandemic. Tell us a little bit about that.
Absolutely. And actually, this is a sign of a great company and reason, one of the reasons why I'm still at GE 30 years later. We really rise to the challenge of the world's problems, be it powering electricity to provide power in, you know, remote areas of the world, or flying people around the world, or in our case, providing healthcare. What's really impressed me is how we've raised to that challenge. So there is, with the COVID-19 virus, just not enough medical equipment in the world to cope with the volumes of people needing ventilators. So we've done a partnership with Ford. So Ford, not typically known for making medical equipment, you're used to making cars. We went to them and we made an agreement to say, can we help each other here? So they're using their manufacturing expertise, their plants, to help produce our ventilators. and they're producing, they will be producing by July up to 50,000 ventilators per month. Similarly, with Ecolog in Germany, their expertise is to create rapid care facilities. You know, every part of the world at the moment needs to boost and increase its capacity for intensive care units and specialist equipment to provide care to COVID patients. So we've partnered with them, they provide the facility, and we're helping to provide the equipment that goes in there that can help with the support of the diagnosis and treatment of COVID-19. And we're doing this in many places across the world. We're trying to see where can we partner. This isn't a decision or a discussion around can we make money. It's about how can we help the world in the crisis situation it's in at the moment. I guess that's what makes me proud about GE. And I'm proud to say that, you know, we're going to face these challenges together.
Scott, thank you so much for your time today. Stay safe and stay well.
Thank you, Ron. Pleasure to speak to you.